Because nerds rule. Geek tested, nerd approved.
Hey guys and gals, it is January 19th, I think. I hope, unless I'm in a distant land. And today, it came actually a bit early, but it's the old nerd block, which, if you saw my video last month, this might be the last nerd block. The whole thing for this month is exclusives, and they're going to have a Better Call Saul item. I'm assuming it's going to be a pop vinyl. That's my guess. And they've teamed up with, like, Team Nerd Play, which apparently is a bunch of cosplayers. And they're offering exclusives based on cosplayers that I could not care less about. And I think they're starting off with trading cards. So, whoop-dee-doo, I'm going to have trading cards from cosplayers. That's great. I will say, this nerd block feels a bit heavier than last month. So, maybe they'll woo me, but, last month was by far the worst I've ever gotten. It's the one that I show friends where I'm like, hey, you thought Nerd Block was bad before. Check this one out. But I'm going to say, if you want to sign up for Nerd Block, there's a link in the video description down below. You can check it out, and it's might be right up your alley. I'm saying it now because I have a feeling I won't want to when this video is over. So, and I don't know what else is going to be in here. So, We'll see. I'm not going to look in the box yet. I want to see the shirt first. Put the box aside. That's a cute shirt. Okay. I like the shirt. I do like the shirt. Central City Sweets Factory. Flashicle. Let me get it where I can actually show the design. It's really hard to do because I'm behind the camera and I can't tell what all you can see. But that's a cute shirt. I like that shirt. I'm actually wearing one of my Nerd Block shirts. So, yay. The shirt's nice. So that's... We're doing okay so far. I honestly cannot remember what last month's shirt was. So, clearly it was a winner. All right. Well, I got two out of three, right? What the heck? What is this? Are you kidding me? All right, well, let's start off with the thing that I'm going to hate the most. And normally, I like to keep the Nerd Block stuff. I thought it could be kind of neat to have, like, just one shelf on a bookcase at some point with all my favorites from the Nerd Block stuff. These will certainly never be on there. Why do we need trading cards of cosplayers? Do people like cosplayers that much? Like, I get it. Like, it's a neat hobby. Some of you are really talented at making your outfits, but my God, do we really need exclusives from cosplayers? Yuffie Bunny. Playing as Heather Mason from Silent Hill. Favorite food, pizza and sushi. Social media. It's got a Facebook and a Twitter link. Monica Lee as Wonder Girl from the new Teen Titans. Favorite food, Fushigi Yugi. These are the worst things in the box. They get kind of better, but this one's not going to be a great box. Leanna Vamp as Daryl Dixon from The Walking Dead. Favorite movie, Mad Max. Megan Marie as Anya Stroud from Gears of War 3. Favorite movie, The Matrix Trilogy. Ashley Hay as Punk Rock Flash. What would your superpower be? Communicate with any living creature. Megan Marie again. As the heart. Based on an illustration by Camilla DiRerico. Jaden Okigio. I'm pronouncing your name wrong. What era would you time travel to into the future. Nicole Marie Jean. Jean as Domino. First cosplay as Baby Doll from Sucker Punch. Wind of the Stars as Junko Inoshima. Favorite food? Sushi. And Abby Darkstar as Indy Abby Jones. Favorite video game, Halo 3. So that's what you can get in a pack of Nerdplay exclusive trading cards from Series 1. 1 in 6 chance for a rare card. Oh gosh golly. Let's open up pack number 2. And 6 minutes. 6 minutes of your life wasted. Oh, I think I got a duplicate already. It's the exact same pack of cards in the exact same order. I'm not even Yuffie Bunny. Yuffie Bunny. Monica Lee. Monica Lee. Leanna Vamp. Leanna Vamp. Megan Marie. Megan Marie. Ashley Hay. Ashley Hay. Yeah. So what? What's the point of including 2 packs of cards if they're exactly the same? Unless I'm just really unlucky and I got the exact same cards in the exact same order in the exact same pack. Unless I'm supposed to get a Series 1 and a Series 2 pack? That's... For card checklist, go to nerdblock.com/nerdplay. No. I don't understand. Like, I get that cosplayers are a lot popular, are a lot more popular than they used to be, and they're everywhere and all that stuff. But I feel like if you're going to make an exclusive for your monthly box, why would you go the cosplay route? Why would you go the trading card route? When I was in middle school, we would collect trading cards of wrestlers. That was it. Wrestlers, and then there was, like, the Divas and, like, the Nitro Girls back when WCW was around. And we had those. Like, we collected those. But that was middle school. Do people still collect cards? My dad loved baseball cards, but I never hear about baseball cards anymore. That put me in a bad mood. That really put me in a bad mood. So, all right. Why are they the same pack? I don't understand. I don't get it. But I'm gonna save that for borderline last. All right. Drum up some ideas. A notepad. That is in the shape of a drum kit, and the pencils have eraser tips that will sound like drums, theoretically. Just I have a knife, but I don't care. I don't care. I'm just gonna tear it. I'm gonna tear it. I can't tear it. What kind of plastic is this? What kind of space age polymer is this? And I can't even tear it! There. So, I mean, I guess this could come in handy. Warning, this bag is not a toy. To avoid danger of suffocation, keep out of reach of children and babies.
So I don't understand how... Why would you have this on the desk?
This could come in handy, I guess, if you're really, really bored and you just... The eraser came off. I'm drumming too hard for my own good. I don't know. You can put your drumsticks in the top if you're not using it, because that doesn't look ridiculous on your desk. This could be entertaining for some people if they're at their desk and they're bored and they just want to drum away. I mean, I guess you could just... Not for me. And it's like, the more you use the pencils, the less your drumsticks are. The more paper you use, the less the drum sound's going to be. It's like, it's going to get low enough where it's going to be just... And I lost the eraser again. So that's... I'm guessing some people are going to love that, but it's not for me. Now, these, I don't know what these are. I do remember they posted in an email... that this was some kind of new thing. And I Googled it. I tried to find more of what clickers were. And I could not find pretty much anything. I saw a couple of pictures that may have been from it, but they looked really, really complex. And I didn't think it would be this. So this is a clickers exclusive item for NerdBlock. And also a shirt punch variant. I don't know what that is. I have no clue what this is. This may be anthrax. And it may be trying to kill me because of my complaining for last month. And it's bend me, twist me, shape me. I'm guessing you could, I don't want to break it, but I'm assuming you can take them apart and... No. I would assume you could actually, like, unclip them and then clip on other ones, and you can make an even longer one, but that's on there really tightly, and I don't want to break it. So, clickers. Is that my mouth? No, or is I don't know. I mean, if I had a really creative personality and imagination, maybe I could make something really nice out of this. But it seems like there's not really enough there to really make a really big shape. You're really limited. You can't even make a bracelet. And I'm assuming the shirt punch variant is just the exact same thing, but with pink instead of the blue. Ah, pink and black. I don't get it. I don't get it. There's not twist your imagination. Like, this is a really, really small space to work with for your imagination. And I guess I could do that. I don't know. I'm sure someone out there is going to be like, oh, that's so cool, and I can make all kinds of things. There's probably people who have made all sorts of landmarks of the world with these, but I just... I don't think I have enough to really... What am I even making? I don't even know. There's my million-dollar idea. Oh, God. I was almost making a swastika for a second there. I don't know. I really don't know. I'm sure people are going to really like this. I hope they have bigger sets and it's not just this. And I'm hoping that these do come unclipped from each other so you can connect them to make bigger ones. I'm not entirely sure if... they're naturally all this small. I didn't want to risk breaking mine because that would be my luck. I would open it and break it. Okay. Something to play with on your desk, I guess, which is fine and dandy. Now, this item I totally called. And it's not even... I'm kind of confused by this because they advertise this as a Better Call Saul exclusive item. They flat out said Better Call Saul exclusive. However, it is Saul Goodman, but it's from Breaking Bad, and it looks like it's just the regular Saul, unless his suit is different. So it's not a pop vinyl. I missed that one entirely. Whenever Nerdblock does a vinyl figure of some kind, it's almost always, that's kind of cute. It's almost always Funko. So it kind of reminds you of like the Mighty Mugs. So this is the same. Okay, this might actually be a variant because on the picture art, he's got a brown suit, and if it's gonna focus, his shirt and tie are a different pattern from this one. So maybe this is a variant, but they advertise you can only get this through Nerdblock, and there's that. So he does come with his World's Greatest Lawyer mug, which is, it's a cute detail to it to include. I am a huge fan of Breaking Bad, and Better Call Saul is a really good show so far. I'm enjoying it. So, you know, it's not bad. If I was ever to get a Breaking Bad vinyl figure for display, I don't know if I would go for Saul. Maybe I would go for a Walt Jr. and hope he came with crutches. But it's not a bad likeness to Bob Odenkirk, at least. So, if I'm pronouncing his name right, probably not. So that's not bad, but it was definitely very, very predicted. So there's that. And the last item. Oh, I forgot about next month's item. All right, so the last item is a Fan Expo variant of Star Wars number 1. Their new comic series, which I have heard pretty good things about. I've heard some reviews are really good. I've heard some where it's kind of like, you know what's going to happen, so what's the point? It's kind of thing. I don't know where this fits into the whole storyline of the movies. Skywalker Strikes, Death Star has been destroyed. Okay, so it's after A New Hope, at least. So I would assume it's after New Hope, before Empire. And the artwork looks really good. I'm totally in a full-on Star Wars kick now. I've gotten a bunch of the games because of Humble Bundle, and I'm really in a Star Wars kick. So this could be a good read, and it's a pretty lengthy comic, unless there's a bunch of just add-ins at the end. Oh, there's Vader. So this could be interesting to read. There's the Falcon right there. And it is a Fan Expo variant cover, so it does make it kind of a rarity. I don't know how much the Fan Expo covers are given out. I know I have the one from Spider-Gwen. What is that? Is Gwen Stacy a spider now? So it takes place at the end of A New Hope. Okay. So, yeah, that's not bad. It's not terrible. And Team Nerdplay. We've signed some of the best cosplayers in the industry to give you one of the most exclusive and exciting cosplay trading card sets ever. That is not a cohesive sentence. That doesn't make any sense. You cannot have a cosplay trading card set and have it be exciting. I'm sorry, you can't. It's people dressed up as other characters. 144 cards to collect. Well, I have 10. Two sets of it. 12 exclusive cosplayers. 1 in 6 chance. Exclusive, as if there's more trading card sets out there for cosplayers. Card packs available only in your Nerdblock subscription. So how are you supposed to get the whole set unless, oh God, are they going to release these every month? You're going to get a new pack of cards. Nerdblock exclusive, 1 in 6 chance to find a rare foil card. Next month's Nerdblock is by Simon Pegg, which they had one a few months ago. It was like Kevin Smith picked what was in the box. And truly, it was just like, here's a Jay and Silent Bob shirt. I think there was like a Batman item, a Star Wars item. It wasn't anything that was really exciting. So while I do like Simon Pegg, I'm kind of torn on this. So Nerdblog is a monthly subscription box with 4 to 6 of the best nerdy collectibles and a pop culture t-shirt. Saving the world will have to wait. I don't know. I'm very, 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 very torn if I want to keep it. This isn't as bad as last month's, aside from the stupid trading cards. But I may wind up canceling anyway. I'll have to see what more of the emails are before you know all that happens. But anyway, this is the exclusive. February Stevens exclusives, Better Call Saul, so we did. And served those Nerdblog exclusive Titan vinyl figures for the popular series Breaking Bad. Saul is available in 3 different suit options that look so good it's almost illegal. Even Heisenberg knows it's Saul good, man. Because, oh God. And yeah, it looks like there's no real variants. I don't know. Oh, there's a contest. Bend me, twist me, shape me, click me, contest. Get creative. Show us the coolest shape you can make with your clickers to win. See, there's a lot of vehicles with a lot of parts that you don't get in the Nerdblog stuff. So they want you to buy the clickers so you can enter the contest where you may win 3 months of a subscription of your choice, an Amazon gift card, and yeah. So that is it for this month's Nerdblock. Not the best, but most certainly not the worst. Last month's was bad. This is a step in the right direction. I like the shirt the more I look at it. I like the shirt a lot more. So I'm liking that. The Better Call Saul figure, while I assume that's what it would be, I like it. I like the show. I like the figure. The Star Wars comic looks really good, and I'm eager to actually read it. As for the trading cards, I don't get it. I really don't. I don't want to get it. I think it's a stupid idea, and that alone makes you want to leave Nerdblock, because if they think that's what people want, unless I'm in the minority, do you guys really like the idea of having trading cards of cosplayers? And better yet, getting 2 sets of the exact same 10 cards. I don't know how that happens, because I thought these were all packaged randomly. So this kind of thing shouldn't happen, even though it totally did. I'm really confused by this. They don't even really feel like high quality cards. So there's that. The drum pad notepad, it's a clever idea, I guess. It's not something that I would ever want to use. So this may be the last Nerdblock video I do. I'm still debating whether or not I should cancel it. It's $30 extra dollars a month I could have you spend on other things, and that is definitely very, very tempting. I've gotten some good things out of Nerdblock over, it's been over a year I've been doing these, and I've gotten some really crappy things. And last month really burned me and my whole opinion of them. And the whole Team Nerdplay thing is just furthering that. So I honestly don't know if I'll continue it. It's been fun if I don't. And if I continue, then clearly I like hurting myself, and you should call for help. Get me the help that I can't get myself. But anyway, I guess that is it for this video. I've covered everything, and I'm done, and I want to get this cleaned up and go do something else. So thanks for watching, as always. I hope you all have a great day or evening, depending on when you're watching this. It's actually night right now for me, so you may be seeing this when it's night. You may be seeing it when it's day. I don't know. But I will see you around, and take care. Bye.